Welcome, students. Today our topic is consumption goods and capital goods. What are consumption goods? Consumption or consumer goods are those goods which are directly used for satisfaction of human wants. These goods are consumed by households like bread, butter, ice cream, milk. There are so many. Now we will classify consumer goods. Consumer goods are classified as durable consumption goods, semi-durable consumption goods, non-durable single-use consumption goods, or services. What are durable consumption goods? These are those goods which can be used for several years. They are of relatively high value, like car, TV, fridge. Semi-durable consumption goods are those goods which can be used for a period of 1 year or slightly more. These goods are not of very high value. For example, clothes, furniture, electric goods, etc. Non-durable or single-use consumption goods are those goods which are used up in a single act of consumption, like bread, butter, same bread, same milk, which cannot be used again and again. These goods are of relatively low value. Services are those non-material goods which directly satisfy human wants, like doctor, teacher, lawyer, etc. Capital goods. Capital goods are fixed assets of the producers, like plant and machinery. These goods are used by producers either for replacement of capital stock or for addition to capital stock. As fixed assets, capital goods are repeatedly used in the process of production for several years. They are of high value. These goods involve depreciation. What is depreciation? Loss of value of fixed assets when these are repeatedly used. We will discuss in the next video in detail. Only those goods which are of high value are the capital goods, repeatedly again and again. Nuts, bolts are used for several years, but they are not capital goods because they are of low value. Students, don't confuse in this concept. We have said fixed assets, capital goods are repeatedly used in the process of production for several years. Earlier we have discussed your durable goods. They were the durable used consumption goods. Now we are discussing capital goods. Now there is a question, all capital goods are producer goods? No. Producer goods are those goods which are used in the process of, which are used in the production of other goods. Producer goods are of two types, single-use producer goods or capital goods. Capital goods are a part of producer goods. So all capital goods are producer goods, but all producer goods cannot be capital goods because producer goods may be intermediate goods, means single-use producer goods or capital goods. What are single-use producer goods? They are intermediate goods. These goods are used as raw material by producers. They cannot be repeatedly used in the process of production. These are non-durable producer goods like wood. It cannot be used again and again. It is used as a raw material. Capital goods. Goods used as fixed assets by the producers. Fixed assets, capital goods are repeatedly used in the process of production for several years. These are durable producer goods like machinery. I think concept is clear. Now, there is the next query of the students. All machines are capital goods? No, all machines are not capital goods. It depends upon their end use. Capital goods are only those durable goods which are used as producer goods, not as consumer goods. For example, a sewing machine in a tailoring shop is a fixed asset of the tailor. It is a capital good. But the same sewing machine with the consumer households is not a capital good. It is simply a durable use consumer good. It depends upon their end use. If the end user of durable good is a household consumer, it is durable use consumer good. If the end user of durable good is a household producer, it is a capital good. Thank you.